I welcome our Chancellor, Dr. Maria Gina Johnson, and our President, Dr. Mary Johnson, for accepting our invitation to preside over the 29th convocation of Satya Bhama Institute of Science and Technology. I also welcome Thiru Sellur K. Raju sir, who is the Minister for Cooperation from the Government of Tamil Nadu, who has come here as a parent to witness his daughter receiving her doctorate degree. I also welcome the eminent members of Board of Management, Vice Chancellor, Pro Vice Chancellors, Directors, Control of Examinations, Deans, Heads of the Departments, Faculty Members, Proud Parents, PhD Degree Recipients, Gold Medalists, and our young graduates, Press and Media. I welcome one and all for the 29th Convocation of Satya Bhama Institute of Science and Technology. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for extending a warm welcome. The powerhouse of our Satya Bhama Institution, our beloved Chancellor, Dr. Maria Gina Johnson, has undoubtedly proven her mettle in the field of higher education. She has gracefully carried over the legacy of our founder Chancellor, Colonel Dr. JPR, and brought it to golden standards. And yes, we are proud to hold the 39th position in NIRF ranking in the whole country and many such prestigious rankings under the able guidance of our dear Chancellor. She views things in a profoundly different prism, rising to every occasion, and she certainly is a game changer with her radical ideas. With her infectious smile and warm personality, she is obsessed with the welfare of our students and workforce. Our Chancellor is driven and relentless in making a better society with her out-of-box social welfare activities like inclusive education, free education for underprivileged students, acid attack victims, women empowerment schemes, village adoption, and the list goes on and on and on. With bravery of spirit and bravery of heart, she is not just changing the lives of individuals, but she is changing generations. Words cannot fully express what she truly is. May I now request our beloved Chancellor of Satya Bhama Institute of Science and Technology, Dr. Maria Gina Johnson, to deliver the presidential address on this wonderful occasion of the 29th Convocation 2020.
With the blessings of our founder Chancellor, Colonel Dr. JPR, and our beloved Dr. Remibai JPR, I'm so happy to preside over the 29th convocation of Satya Bhama Institute of Science and Technology. Respected Chief Guest of the Day, Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Dr. Edappadi K. Palaniswamy Sir, Respected Director of IG Car Kalpakam, our President, Dr. Murray Johnson, members of the Board of Management, Vice Chancellor Dr. T. Sasiprabha, Pro Vice Chancellors, Registrar, Directors, Deans, Faculties, Special Invitees, officials from various press and media, parents, and my dear graduates. A very good morning to one and all of you. I'm really pleased to be with you today on this very auspicious day. It is a great matter of pride and happiness that our Honorable Chief Minister is with us today. We consider ourselves very fortunate that we have a great leader and administrator like Sir with us today. Sir, you have given your valuable time to grace this occasion and bless our young graduates. We respect you for your distinct vision for our state, especially for the younger generation. You are an ideal of knowledge and experience and inspiration to all of us. Thank you so much, sir, on behalf of all of us. எங்களின் அன்பான முதல்வர், எங்களின் பாசமிகு தலைவர், எங்களின் பெருமைமிகு விவசாயி, முக்கியமாக எங்கள் மாணவர்களின் முதல்வர், நன்றி ஐயா. I extend my warmest congratulations to all the young and brilliant minds, the gold medalists, and the candidates who are receiving their PhD research degrees today under various disciplines. Each of the graduate student is the ambassador of our university. You have earned your degree today, but your education has just begun. We wish you all enormous success in all your future careers, knowing that your success will mark the success of our institution. I strongly believe that you will all immensely contribute to the nation and the society. At this moment, I would like to quote my father, Colonel Dr. JPR. No matter what happens in your life, always face it with a smile. Nothing is permanent in this world. When your time comes, serve all equally with a lot of respect, gratitude, and humility. He is always blessing us from above. I offer my respects and congratulations to the proud parents who supported you throughout your entire journey in our campus. The best feeling in the world is to know that your parents are smiling because of you. Take care of your parents always. They are the most precious gift God has given you. My wholehearted gratitude and appreciation to the academic heart of our university. Yes, our faculties, the teaching, the non-teaching, and the leadership of our institution. They have all aided in shaping your education through the values and the career ahead. Their exemplary hard work and devotion is the bedrock in which our university is built. Always honor your teachers. Dear graduates, go confidently in the direction of your dreams. Train your mind to see the good in everything you see. Positivity is the choice, but the happiness of your life depends in the quality of your thoughts. Always remember, you are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. Go into the world well, but always do good in this world. Go. What happens yesterday is just gone. Tomorrow is just another day. If you get tired, learn to rest, but never, never quit. The greatest gift of the graduates today, what you earned throughout your life in this university, are your friends. Never forget them. Friends, they never say goodbye to you in your life. They are the sunshine of your life. At this moment, I wish each one of the graduating students all the very best. When your tomorrow comes, accept the fact that you will always keep learning and learning in your life. Continue the education process in your life. I have each one of you in my heart. Wishing you all a lot of happiness, peace, and good health. Always be proud of yourself. And all the progress in your life is all because of your hard work. Unnai arindal, nee unnai arindal, ulagathil poradalam, uyarndalum, thaalndalum, thalai vanangamal nee vaalalam. Stay united, our country, our pride. Jai Hind.
Thank you, ma'am. Your constant motivation always inspires us to keep giving our best. I would now like to invite Dr. G. Sundari, Director, Administration, to read the citation on our Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Thiru Edappadi K. Palaniswami Aiyar Avargal.